Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Doris. I'm here to share with you about my stock account and today's market update. Right now, the net asset of my account is 63,461.61. Today, I've made a loss of 2.61% in United Natural Gas. SPY, it closed down 0.16%. SQQ closed up 2.54%. And Apple has closed down 1.21%. The market generally closed lower today. Nasdaq closed down 0.52%. S&P 500 closed down 0.19%. And Dow Jones Industrial Average closed up 0.1%. Today, the loss is mainly led by Tesla, and today Tesla has in total made a loss of 4.54%. So today, Wells Fargo's analysts have released a report analyzing Tesla's reason for its decline and its future prospects. And let's take a look at how. Since last year, the pace of expansion of Tesla's revenue and profits has slowed significantly. The stock is down 32% year-on-year and missed out on a broad rally that drove S&P 500 up 8.3%. Wells Fargo's analyst noted the company's slowing growth in its core markets, downgrading the stock to the equivalent of a sale on Wednesday. Langen wrote in a note to clients that electric vehicle makers are now in a growth company with no growth. He stressed that the sales in the second half of 2023 increased by only 3% compared to the first half, while the prices fell by 5%. Since the end of 2022, Tesla has repeatedly cut prices in the Chinese market, triggering an international price war. The troubles with Tesla and electric cars began in mid-October, when Elon Musk's company first warned of a slowdown in demand. But market sentiment deteriorated further after Tesla said in early January that growth would slow significantly this year. Other automakers, electric vehicle suppliers, and even car rental companies have made similarly cautious comments. While weak electric vehicle demand has caused trouble for all car companies, Tesla's share price, a pure electrical vehicle company with a surprisingly high valuation, has taken a hard hit. Since the beginning of the year, Tesla's market value has fallen sharply, and Elon Musk's personal net worth has dropped from the top one in the world to the third, losing more than $5.75 billion. Analysts lowered the company's 2024 earnings per share forecast from 2.4 to 2. Currently, Wall Street analysts are expecting an average of $3.03 per share for Tesla this year. And then let's talk about the yield on the 10-year Treasury notes that has been fluctuating a lot recently. Treasury yields rose further on Wednesday as markets continue to further digest the impact of Tuesday's inflation data on the Fed's outlook for interest rates cuts this year. While the U.S. Treasury yields continue to rise, U.S. growth stocks were gradually feeling the pressure. The three main U.S. stock indexes were mixed overnight, and technology stocks fell significantly. Market data showed that the U.S. Treasury yields of all maturities generally rose overnight. By the end of the New York session, a two-year Treasury yield was up 5.4 basis points at 4.649%. The five-year Treasury yield was up 4.7 basis points at 4.02%. The 10-year yield was up 3.3 basis points at 4.193%. And the 30-year was up 2.7 basis points at 4.343%. This is the third consecutive session of higher yields on the 10-year Treasury note, which has the anchor of global asset pricing. Earlier, the U.S. Labor Department reported on Tuesday that the U.S. Consumer Price Index rose 0.4% month-on-month in February, a higher-than-expected increase, mainly affected by higher gasoline and housing costs. Traders in the interest rate futures market are now betting the Fed will cut interest rates in June from 70% on Tuesday to 66.7%, according to FedWatch tool. As we're now in a period of silence again ahead of the March meeting, there are no Fed officials scheduled to speak on the economic calendar this week. Experts have said that there is a common dynamic since December that the markets expect the Fed's wanting to do something, either dropping the interest rates. However, what the Fed expects for the U.S. economy, which is a more conservative point. Markets have been closely watching the new data that reflects the trajectory of U.S. economic growth and can provide guidance to the central bank's plans to cut interest rates. Tuesday's CPI and a series of previous reports have undoubtedly caused many people in the industry to worry about a rebound in inflation. This is all I have for today. Thank you for listening. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next episode.